Welcome to CSSE480, Web App Frameworks with Google App Engine. So the goal of this course is web development, right? So we call it web app development. And specifically, we said frameworks just because there's a lot of different tools that we're going to use in the world of web development to try to make your life a lot easier, right? So web development is highly fragmented. There's so many ways to do different things. We have to kind of pick one. So I picked the tools that I think are the best and show them to you, right? So we're going to be using AppEngine for most of the things we're doing in this course. And we're going to build on top of that with other tools. So we're going to be using, of course, the Chrome browser quite a bit. It's got dev tools that I like. We're going to be using Bootstrap for a lot of our UI development. I think it's a really good framework for doing UI things. jQuery, of course, for doing a lot of our JavaScript. Our backends are going to be written in Python. We're going to be using the cloud data store to store all of our data on the backend. We're also going to be doing a ton with CSS and with JavaScript. So that's kind of the highest level of the key buzzwords that we're going to be learning about. Suppose I should probably introduce myself as well. So I'm a Rose-Hulman professor, been here since 2005. I was actually a Rose-Hulman undergrad as well. So this R is for because I was an undergrad here. I started in 96. Went and did my PhD at Stanford. That was actually in biomechanics, had nothing to do with web development. Got back on as a professor here after 5 years at Stanford, so 2005. Other interesting factoids about me is I've gotten to work at both Apple and Google. So I've been a summer contractor numerous times at Apple, kind of doing firmware development and some iOS things. My sabbatical work, I was at Google for a year and a half doing some web development there with the Google TV team. So I've done a lot of really fun things. I also, you know, even more importantly, noticed that if you rearrange this logo and you put that one there and you kind of slide that one this way, you can actually rearrange these different logos and make the word Rose. I'm not sure what practical value that has, but I found that really interesting when I was making these slides. More about this course. So the goal by the end of this course is that you can put up websites with Google App Engine. You can use Bootstrap. You can use jQuery. You can do a lot of interesting things with CSS to make like flexible, responsive UIs. Responsive means if you go to mobile, it still looks good. You go to a huge widescreen, it still looks good. And everything in between, right? So that's kind of one of the goals of this course. The prerequisites is that you come in with some programming experience. There's enough that you need to learn in programming that you've got to come in with something. I also want you to know a little bit about the basic of like HTML and kind of how the web works. If you don't, we'll get you caught up. If you have a lot of experience, hopefully you'll find some new things in this course interesting as well. You're not required to know any of these frameworks to kind of start things off. So that's just kind of setting the groundwork. If you want to read the formal course description, here it is, right? Pause the video, go through and read it. There's a lot of good stuff in there, but it's kind of hard to digest when you're kind of getting going in the class. To kind of break the course down, we've broken it into different tracks. So we're actually going to be working on an App Engine track first, and we're going to be working through some things there. Then we're going to get into the CSS and then the JavaScript. If you actually know these topics already, you'll kind of discover that these are out of order. Really, if you wanted to build from the ground up, you would learn like, you know, HTML and CSS, and then you would learn JavaScript, and then you would learn a back-end tool like AppEngine. But we've actually put AppEngine first, and that like leads the course off. And the reason we've done that is not that I'm crazy. It's that these are the skills that are most important for your project, right? So if we want you to actually like start thinking about your project in like week two or three, we got to show you AppEngine first, right? And so it'll give you the big picture of kind of how the CSS and JavaScript and backend all kind of tie together. And so we're going to do that track first. There will be some things, if you don't have a strong background in web development, that are a little painful. Like we'll show you some CSS things. You're like, man, I'm getting blown away here. And some JavaScript things that are a little complex. But you know what? We'll make it work, right? But the goal is to get you the important skills that you need for your project as quick as we can in this course. The other skills are important too. They're just not as critical. If you don't know them, you could still make a project, right? So that's kind of the structure of the tracks in this course. As far as demos of things you'll build, you'll find that this class is very, very application focused. So there's a ton of things we're going to have you build. I'll just kind of bring up one of the students in this class. we have you make up a portfolio of like all the things you make in this class. So all of the things that you made in the App Engine track have links. All the things that you made in the CSS track, you know, there's a lot of individual assignments have links. The JavaScript track has links. So you're going to make a page like this that's kind of a portfolio of all your work, including your project. And then if you were to click on one of these links, you know, it'd take you to that. So here's the movie quotes one, which is something we'll do in the early going. Here's a weather picks web app, which we're going to teach you in the early going, and this is kind of what it looks like. We're also going to show you things like custom domains. So for example, here's one I've reserved, dicewithfriends.com. Really, it just forwards to an appspot.com, which is what App Engine uses. And we're going to teach you things like, you know, how do I sign in and sign out? We're going to teach you how to do it with Google login, but you could also do it with your own mechanism if you wanted. And so in this app, I'm actually just going to like challenge someone to a game. And I'm going to challenge Rose-Hulman Fisher, which is also me. And so this is a game where we teach you some of like, how do I make interactions with JavaScript for this particular game? How do I, you know, hit stop and save things on the data store? And how do I present this individual user's information to them? So that's like one of the concepts that we're going to be doing. We're also going to be doing a lot of work with local host development. So local host development is when you're running something local on your machine before you push it to the world. So this one is a tic-tac-toe app, admittedly against a terrible computer player. And if I win, it makes noise. And the idea is that we're doing, you know, some Ajax things to like get information from the back end, some JavaScript things. We'll also be doing some CSS things so that it reflows nicely on different pages. But these are some examples of the things we're going to build. I could go on and on about things we're going to build, but it would take like hours. The structure of this course is that no matter what track you're in, like, you know, App Engine, JavaScript, or CSS, there's going to be units. Unit is kind of like the topic for that week or however long the chunk of time takes. Inside each unit, there's going to be a video activity, so on and so forth, until you finally get to the lab. Some of them are structured slightly different, but that's kind of the idea. You can click on the links over here, and you can kind of like see what one of these tracks looks like. So here's the JavaScript track and the things that are currently in it. And then if you click on the next link, it'll take you to the unit. So the unit here is JavaScript basics. So you can see that there's a video that you can watch. It's kind of like this one. It's got its little intro screen and me in the corner talking. After the video, you'll go answer some questions. So if you get the questions right, you can move on. It doesn't actually stop you. You could move on without answering correctly. I do really recommend you do the questions, though. That's where you're going to really learn a lot. And then as you kind of go through video activity, you'll eventually get to a lab. And so there's kind of an intro to each lab, which is a video. But then there's a really in-depth handout for all the things that you're going to have to do in that lab. So that's kind of an example of some of the things we're going to be doing in this class and what a unit feels like. As far as the graded assignments go, there's going to be follow-alongs, which are things you do while watching the videos. There's going to be labs, which is largely from App Engine and JavaScript. And there's going to be exercises, which is usually the CSS track. There's also exams and a final project, which I'll talk about in a little bit. The way you're going to be turning things in this class is everything is a URL, right? You're deploying everything and making it up as a website. And so the only thing you're going to be submitting to me is what URL you used when you did it. And then if you wanted to like check to make sure you've submitted it, you can just go to where you submitted it. And here it just says to me, I've already submitted that one. So it's kind of weird that all the submissions are just going to be giving me the URL of the work you did. It's a web development class. The due dates are going to be either Monday noon, Wednesday noon, or Friday noon. So there never is any other due time, right? So like Sunday night or Tuesday night or Thursday night, you might be worried, is there anything due tomorrow? But you never have to worry on a Friday night if there's something due like the next day. If you submit something on time, it's eligible for 100%. If you miss a deadline, like let's say it was supposed to be due Wednesday noon and you just miss it. If you submit it before the Friday noon one, you can still get 50% of the credit, right? And the same goes for Friday. If you miss the Friday noon deadline, you can still submit it by Monday noon and get 50% of the credit. It's kind of a harsh system, so submit things on time, right? But there is a little bit of wiggle there to get some points instead of nothing. If you miss the next deliverable, it won't be worth points. I'm not going to go back and grade them. Sorry. As far as the breakdown of the weights of these different things, here's kind of a rough approximation of the weights. There will be a couple exams in the course, and you can see how much I value the project in this class as well, and how I weight it, more important than anything else. As far as the letter grades go, following a typical Rose-Hulman scale, 90, 85, 80, nothing surprising there. As far as what we expect in the project, let's just kind of start by looking at examples. There's a ton of examples here. I just kind of picked one. So this one is Royal Mandarin Order. So Royal Mandarin Order is just a student project. It's not like an official thing with the Royal Mandarin Company. It's just a student project. They've got a way that you can log in. I've already logged in here. And what they've got is they've made a menu system, you know, to where you can add things to your cart depending on what you would like to buy and the prices for each thing. And then whenever you're done with each thing, you can go to a checkout. Their current checkout is that you can put your credit card information in here if you like, or you can claim that you'll pay with cash whenever you go pick up it, which is the recommended thing. And there's a way that you can view your past orders, and there's a lot of really interesting things about this website. And it's not the only one, right? I mean, there's a ton of these things. This is another one. They're playing Bounce Town. So in Bounce Town, I can create a new game, and then I can, you know, play against somebody else. And so this team had to learn a lot about, you know, canvas drawing and how do I do things like this. And that's really one of the goals of the project, is I want you to think of something that you think would be fun, that you'd like to learn a little bit more about. We didn't cover any sort of canvas drawings in this class, but it's something that this team wanted to work on and that they found really interesting. And if you wanted to do something like this, you totally could. As far as the deliverable, there's a bunch of examples on here. Notice how they're all custom domains. That's one of the requirements of the project. There are a bunch of requirements for the project. You know, it has to look good, it has to provide value, it has to look good on websites, for desktop, for mobile, things like that. You could read all of the information in here as far as what we're expecting you to do in your project. As far as the classroom communications go, everything you really need is on Moodle. There are links in Moodle so you can see what's supposed to be due then. As far as the announcements and forums, we're going to put those on Piazza just because I really like Piazza. There's also some external links you'll go to from Moodle if you want to do things like that as well. That's kind of the basics of what this course is all about. That's the high level view. Look forward to seeing you as soon as you start getting into the details of all these units. I hope you really like it. All right, see you next time. Bye.